Friday tip video. Now, this video is going to be about how to disguise your defense in a non-traditional way. So I'm going to come out in double safety blitz, okay? I'm going to come out versus just 2x2, and I'm just going to pick what random play here. Now, the thing that I'm trying to work on and show you is you can show a blitz look and play different coverages out of it. So I'm going to come out in just a regular 2-safety linebacker blitz, bringing everybody in the box, and it's going to be cover 0. The one thing I like to do, and the whole idea of what today's video is, you can show coverage disguises with baseline. You can show we're playing a 2-high shell. You can show we're playing a 4-across umbrella look, but I like to show it from an up look, right? Now, the traditional way, that old school way of doing it is show blitz, right? Press everybody on every play. I like it like this. I like it that I'm showing a natural look that the game has naturally, and I'm going to get to other coverages by it. So I'm coming out and showing some stuff here, right? You can do this and you can align and you can do anything you want. Right, you can really get to any coverage you want. Now you need to be smart about how you do it, make sure guys aren't out of position, but I'm gonna play 2-man. So out of your audibles, just check the 2-man, and the safeties do not go back, they stay down. So here's the tip: anytime you wanna show a look that's an aggressive look, pick a defense from this front. This is a nickel front, right? You can do it from really any front, doesn't matter if it's base, doesn't matter if it's dime, doesn't matter if it's dollar, and you can actually take it and check it to whatever defense that you want, and the safeties will not come down as long as they walk down pre-snap on their own. And if you play in certain leagues, you play in sim leagues like I'm in, you can't control, you can't manually move safeties, you can't manually move anybody that you're not controlling full time. So this allows you to allow your defense to have some movement to it and play different things. You don't have to play 2-man, you don't have to put your corners on an island and hope that your safeties get back. You can play cover 4, you can play cover 6 invert, one of my favorite coverages to play this year, because when you look at the play art, look at this, right? This safety that came down, he is actually a curl flat defender, so he's aligned in the right position. And this safety over here is a quarters defender, and he has to play number 2. If number 2 goes vertical, 1 and 2 go vertical, right? So here's the deal, like, that he's not in a horrible position. And sometimes in Madden, when you're playing deep zones from up close, you can actually get better coverage from a guy who's playing down here in the box, is because we are playing Madden, we're not playing real football. And also you get an extra run defender versus the run. That's another thing about this: anytime you walk a safety down in the box, a lot of times people will be discouraged to run the ball. So for example, one of my other favorite ways of doing it, you don't have to bring 2 safeties down, you can play it on a different level, right? So I'm going to show you a defense here. Where is it at? Here we go. Safety strong 3, right? I'm going to come out, let's just say 2x2 again, random play, right? A lot of times I'm using offensive formations that people use a lot. So you see how the safety came down? This is the look. This is a blitz. This is a play that I run. I like to run it for different reasons, but I definitely like to run it versus teams that like to run inside zone or run the ball. And a lot of times what happens is naturally when you will do this versus 2x2 or 3x1, they normally will come down to the strong side of the formation strength, which is usually the opposite side of the back, and the back is going to normally go from right to left on the screen. So it kind of discourages the run game, right? So that's kind of naturally what happens. People are going to now start checking out of the run play, thinking pass. And what can you do from here? You can check to whatever coverage you want, right? So I can check the 2-man, right? Corners come down. You can even back the corners off with a, well, you don't have to click on them to do that. You can do that with your controls, right? But now look at this. I'm playing basically an 8-man box football, but I'm playing 2-high defense. Why do I like to do this again? I like to do it to discourage people from doing certain things. I also like to do it versus teams that are really good passes, man. Like, I'm struggling, man. I can't get nothing going. I got no pressure. I want to give them that next level of thinking, right? I can also come down like this, send the blitz. I can play a 2-high shell. I can stay in a 3-high shell, right? So I can play, I have in my audible set up already right now, I have 3 buzz, right? So I'm playing 3 buzz. He's a hook curl defender. He came down looking like he's going to blitz. Now he's just going to play exactly where he's standing. So you're going to get this type of look. So I'm trying to open your mind to maybe different ways to disguise naturally. All right, here's an advanced level tip. There are certain fronts in the game that allow you to play a single high defense look really from the jump, and if you audible, it will go back into it. So let me just kind of explain it visually a lot better than to talk about it. I'm gonna come out, I'm gonna go 3x1 here, okay? Big nickel is one of these type of fronts, all right? I call front because a front is really necessarily how the guys line up front, right? So I call it a front, not a formation, but it is a formation. I came out in cover 3. Cover three looks like this. We all know a cover three. Most people, when they play you, they're thinking it's either cover three or cover one, right? Could be cover one off, could be cover three. It could be some type of pressure look or whatever, but most likely this is what it is, okay? This kind of ties into watch my last video, right? I had that free safety blitz three look where this guy was down, right? But this is a little bit different because he's already walked, when the play starts, he's already down early. He's already lined up. He's not walking down. So people probably are thinking this is not a pressure look, this is cover three. But check this out. I'm gonna call two man, right? I'm just gonna call cover two man, right? As long as the offense doesn't snap the ball quickly, watch how the computer free safety comes back down into this alignment. Beautiful. So you're not sure from an offensive point of view. And this only happens in big nickel. One of the reasons why I like big nickel, right? So let's do something else here, okay? Again, so you have to call, I think it works in cover one as well, but I know it works in cover three sky and cover three match, right? So you can check out cover three on your own, cover one on your own. But I'm just gonna call whatever. It doesn't matter what I'm calling on offense. Again, I'm gonna call four palms, right? Call four palms here, right? Everybody gets lined up to start in four palms and the safety comes back down and aligns in the position as he was in three sky, and I'm playing four palms from this position. Again, I think it's powerful to be able to play two high defenses, quarters defenses, man defenses, where you align in a single high look and you can now give that guy something extra to think about. It's kind of untraditional, right? And there's another front defense here that's a little bit different. So the mechanics of over 4-3 over, I'm running more 4-3 defenses this year. You can look at it at a 3-4, I'm not sure, but I do know this: if you call 4-3 over, and this is like an old school going back 10 years type of thing here, okay, and most likely you're gonna get some type of normal formation. Let me see, I'm using the Ravens playbook, so they don't have a lot of just under center normal formations, right? Here we go, strong, okay, under center, two back defense, right? I'm calling two man, right? I'm just calling two man under. If you press old school way, right, press your defense, right? So I'm pressing triangle on a PlayStation and I press, right? This gets everybody to press. But most of the time, in most defenses, most fronts, when you press, both safeties come down, right? They both are like within 10 yards and they're lined up looking like they're gonna blitz. However, in this defense, in 4-3 over, they go into a three high shell look. They go into a one press shell look, right? You see how this safety stayed back and this one came up, all right? So now you can still, and what happens from here, you can now play your cover, you can play a two high shell just by pressing the defense. So it's not a traditional press. If you know what I'm talking about, you know that when you traditionally press a defense, everybody comes down. But when you do it here out of the 4-3 under, they get into a cover one look. So that's a nice little tip. You can kind of use all the things that I just talked about how you can check into different plays. But here is a little bit more different. Like, let's say I want to run a cover two, okay? And God forbid, I know this is not sound, but you know, I'm going to play cover two, right? But I'm going to show cover three. I'm gonna show cover one. Maybe short yardage, you wanna try to do this. Now, this guy has to get back to a deep half, not the most sound thing in the world, but if a team sees this, they're not gonna be thinking you're in cover two. They may not, right? Especially if I back the corners off with my, just quick adjustments there. They're thinking this is cover three, and you might be able to get somebody sneaking a ball to the flat, trying to get you on third and one, third and short, and try to do something like that, right? So I just want to kind of talk through that. This is called a non-traditional way to show to disguise coverage, not the meta way, not the way that everybody usually does it. I think these ways you can use in all different types of settings to really kind of get try to confuse somebody a little bit. Check out my other video from last week. It was a good video. I think you learned something about how to stop some crossing routes. But this one is a kind of like an overall tip video. It's very easy to set up. All you have to do is just think about how you want to set somebody up, go into a game, do a couple things, and then go from there. Okay? Talk to you guys later, man. I hope you enjoyed it. Happy Friday. Peace.